For this video, we have conducted an experiment where we will be using eggs in order to represent microorganisms. Now for this, we have chemically removed the shell of the eggs, leaving them inside of a semi-permeable membrane. This will represent the cell membrane. The conalbumin, or egg white, is going to be our cytoplasm, and the yolk will represent our nucleus. We will be putting these eggs under three different stresses, which certain microorganisms have evolved to resist. The first stress that we'll be putting an egg under is high salinity, or a high concentration of salt. So for this, we will fill the bottom of a beaker with table salt. Place our shellless egg on top of the salt, and then bury the egg in table salt. Our second egg will be subjected to sub-zero temperatures by being left in the freezer. Unfortunately, our third egg did not resist the open air very effectively and did unfortunately burst. After our two remaining eggs have been left in their stresses overnight, this is now how they look. But let's first turn our attention towards our egg under sub-zero temperatures. This egg has frozen solid to the beaker, and to take it out, this did require a bit of additional leverage. It is immediately evident that the membrane did not resist the cold. This egg is frozen completely solid. But to really test this, we are going to need to crack it open. Clearly, using a table is not going to work for this, so we're going to a bit more of a heavy-duty method. The egg has been placed within our workbench vise, and we have opted to crush it to see the interior. At this point, the membrane of the egg has begun to crack, and we see it start to open. It is indeed clear that our cell, represented by an egg, did not survive the cold conditions. It has completely frozen through, even to the point which its cell membrane that would have been protecting it is easily pulled away from the cytoplasm and the nucleus. Let's see if our high salinity cell did any better. So we'll pour all of this out and then scrape the salt away from the egg. Surprisingly, our egg does seem to be mostly intact. It does feel a bit softer. There's a bit more of a give on the cell membrane. It is possible that some of the cytoplasm has been pulled through the semi-permeable membrane and absorbed by the salt. and it's definitely not resistant to any pressure. Were our results what you would have expected from this experiment?